what have we come here for?
As travel writers, we often visit places during low season. Fewer tourists mean more access for us.
This time we've arrived in Belize and it's rainy season, so we're leaving the beaches and coral reefs behind and heading inland.
Instead of diving into the Caribbean, we're going underground.
It's absolutely beautiful.
And through the jungles. Oh. My wrist is so hurting.
What's new? What's different? What's surprising in Belize? Travel writers cover different beats.
I tackle the quirky cultural side of travel.
I find edgy, risk-taking stories.
The trick is to find stories that inspire.
And the stories that sell. What have we come here for? With English as its official language, Belize prides itself on its diversity, with a small population of just over 300,000, made up of English, Spanish, Creole, and Mayan speakers.
This is different, but few tourists stay in the capital for very long. Like them, we have two options. Head to the Caribbean coast to explore the second largest barrier reef in the world, or head inland, where thick jungles and ancient ruins provide a different sort of adventure.
It's the rainy season, so we head out to a remote jungle lodge, and the fastest way to get there is by speedboat. We cruise along the winding river, spotting iguanas, kingfishers, and other exotic birds. With a bit of luck, we could have spotted the elusive jaguar, known to roam these parts.
I love the jungle, but this isn't the first one I visited. This lodge offers something a bit different. It does research on endangered crocodiles, an interesting fact and a good story angle.
Started out, they have this whole thing about never being jaded. I'm never going to be jaded.
With the amount of travel I do, sometimes it can become routine. I wonder if one day I'll lose that excitement, that thrill of arriving in a place I've never been before. So take me to the river, I can almost feel
it. The world is washing over me. Do you mind if he speeds it up a little bit? You can get some bumps.
Oh, you always trying to get adrenaline out of everything.
Come on, Julia, please.
Does it always have to be an adrenaline act?
That was awesome. Saw a lot of birds.
Do you see any crocodiles?
No, the crocodiles are very shy. Have you eaten crocodile before?
No.
Tastes like chicken.
Everything tastes like chicken.
We are greeted on Lamini's wooded pier by blue cocktails and smiling staff.
Thank you. These are Blue Lagoon?
Yeah.
Thanks. I'll take three. Hey, Julia.
Oh, wow. This is great.
Welcome to the jungle.
Thank you. Cheers.
Oh, yummy.
I love hammocks. I'm just noticing there's some hammocks.
Once we're settled, the plan is to go check out a crocodile's nest as part of the lodge's research project. An ecotourism story could be just the hook we're looking for.
There's only one way to do the jungle. In style.
Okay, well, I'm off to do the crocodile adventure. And it should be pretty cool because they actually pick the crocs out of the water and put them on your lap. The only problem is the weather does not look promising. There's a big storm coming in our direction, but I'll give it a try anyway.
We take a dugout canoe to meet up with one of Lamini's resident researchers on the other side of the lagoon. Researchers, along with scientists, track and monitor the endangered Morlet crocodile. They count eggs and ensure everything is healthy in the environment.
This is a Morlet crocodile nest.
See where the eggs are?
We meet up with Maurizio, a naturalist with the lodge who is collecting data on the crocodiles.
We're gonna open the nest, see where the eggs are, find them.
And then to do a counting, see how many eggs there are in the nest.
It's very exciting. I've never seen crocodile eggs.
Me neither.
Whenever you handle a crocodile egg, you cannot turn them around. But whenever you lift them up, you need to make sure you put them back in the same way you find them.
Okay.
Just be very gentle.
We're told to be gentle in order to not disturb its gestation. You would like to hold it?
I'm good.
Oh my gosh.
These little ones are great, but I'm excited to see the big ones.
We'll try hard to catch one tonight, bring it on board, take some data, and everything should be okay.
We're going to do some research with the real thing.
Cool. Okay, well, look out for Mama. I want to see the big one, but I want to see it from the safety of our boat.
As the sun sets, a tropical rainstorm rolls in. We're told the heavy rains could wash away our chance to see the crocs.
Tell me again why we travel in low season. Oh, God.
Traveling in Belize during off-season typically means bad weather.
The heavy rains last night washed away our chances to research crocs. So we head out to explore some Mayan ruins.
I don't even know how to mimic that. It's like a growling.
You need to channel your inner monkey.
He likes it.
It's only a short walk from the lodge to the Lamanai ruins, some of the oldest in Central America.
What's great is that there's no tourists here.
Yeah, it's 6 o'clock in the morning.
Ancient civilizations, mystical practices, lost secrets. Ruins incite imagination. They conjure up images of antiquated battles, divine sacrifices, and romanticized ideas of what once was.
I've seen lots of Mayan ruins before, but usually there are flashy signs, boardwalks, and hordes of tourists.
Should we check out the top?
This is the highest point in the region we're gonna get to.
I hear it has a great view. If I can make it up there, my God.
Come on, Julia, you're doing so well. Burn off those enchiladas, come on.
Rising over 100 feet, the view from atop is stunning, the highest point in the area. Thick green jungle stretches in every direction on the flat escarpment.
When we started being travel writers, we kept on having this whole thing about not becoming jaded.
Are you turning into that guy?
I'm worried. I'm worried because I've done a lot of Mayan ruins and I want to have the enthusiasm to be here. I'm enthusiastic because it's early and there are no tourists. That's really the best thing about being here at the moment. But I can't really get buzzed about the history as I once was.
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess when you see a lot of Mayan ruins, that initial impact, it's not there because you've seen so many of them.
It's important to keep experiencing new things, not only for myself, but for my readers too. It's a challenge to keep coming up with new ideas, but I love it.
This isn't my first time seeing Mayan ruins, but there's something special about visiting the oldest Mayan site, and all on our own.
It's a tough decision what to do when you've got this 1 week and you can go to a specific place. You know, you can't get and see and do everything. We both chose the jungle.
I wanted jungle survival so badly, so when I found out I could do it here, I had to.
And I wanted to go caving. But if I didn't have that caving, I would have fought you hard for the beach.
Yeah, I know. You hate the jungle. It's too many mosquitoes, that's why. There you go. Classic Robin right there.
We're on our way to Caves Branch, an eco-lodge offering a complete menu of jungle adventures.
Welcome to Caves Branch Jungle Lodge.
Thank you.
We need to sign papers and stuff, sign your waiver. That's the part where we say you sign your life away. And I guess you guys definitely need to do that. Snakes, scorpions, spiders.
Yeah, not so brave now.
We'll see. He'll be screaming in the middle of the night. It won't be Julia. It'll be Robin.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, a scorpion. Oh.
That's a lie.
It's so beautiful. A towel in the shape of an elephant.
Here we have your jungle shower.
Jungle shower?
Oh, yes, take a look.
Beautiful. I think I could get used to this.
Julia's excited about her jungle survival, and I'm psyched to go spelunking amongst Mayan ruins. So we meet with our guides to learn about the dangers of the jungle.
We have a snake, which is the most poisonous one, which is the ferulans. Okay, and he's the most common one.
Snakes and jaguars? I hope none of these work their way into my story tomorrow, or any of them into my sheets tonight.
Some people like the mountains, some people love the ocean. For me, there's something about jungles and rivers. I just love it. That is where I'm at home. I've been trying to do this jungle survival trek forever, and for whatever reason, it always keeps falling through. So when I found out I could do it in Belize, I wanted to sign up immediately.
Oh, look at this, Julia. We've got the marching army ant.
Ching, my guide, will teach me the survival basics, how to make shelter, find water, and set handmade traps to catch small birds and animals.
So what do I need when I'm out here?
What you really need out here also is this. Without this, you can't survive out here. This is your bread and butter out here.
A machete.
A machete.
Stand back. Bend it.
Survival, your puny life depends on how much you fight.
The jungle is a good example of survival of the fittest. Here, even the plants, like this one, they can even hurt you.
With few fine dining options in the jungle, desperate times call for desperate measures.
What else do you have out here?
We have rats.
Rats.
Rats. Big rats.
It keeps getting better.
This is a home of a big rat known as the paca. He's actually fully vegetarian, and they can get up to about 15, 20 pounds in weight. I'm gonna let you hold on to this.
All right, thank you.
We make the trap out of a small tree and use peeled bark to make the rope that we need for a noose. How do you know all this stuff?
Growing up, we learned this kind of stuff.
From your father?
Father, yeah.
So it's been passed on from generation passing, to
yeah.
generation.
Over the years, I've eaten many weird things, but I'm not sure my stomach can handle eating jungle rat. We set the trap and wait.
Morning washes over the jungles of Belize. Cave's branch rests on a foundation of soft limestone, and with regular tropical rainfall, it creates perfect conditions to form hundreds of miles of caves and underground river systems.
A lot of people come to Belize and they head for the coast, but exploring Mayan caves, that's something
that's
Indiana
Jones. That's intense, yeah. We get a lot of hardcore people that come around here and do that type of caving. So are you ready for it, man?
I think I can handle it.
It's these caves and rivers that will provide the backdrop to my story. Definitely one geared to the more adventurous traveler, and that's right up my alley. My guide for this caving adventure is Pablo. He's taking me to the Waterfall Cave, discovered by trappers and hunters in the 1950s. Further exploration in the 1970s revealed that the Mayans had used this system for centuries before. Using specialized equipment, ropes, and harnesses, spelunkers seek out cave systems that run for dozens of miles, requiring contortionist techniques, rock climbing skill, and the instincts of a navigator.
Okay, so somebody stumbles across this, and the next thing you know, they're finding Mayan artifacts, pottery, bones, and waterfalls.
That's right, in here you have it all.
See, that's exploring. That's the real thing. Wow, it's beautiful.
It's a huge cave, huh? You can hear the sounds of the waterfall in there already.
Yeah.
At the mouth of the cave, I'm acquainted with the extraordinary creatures that inhabit this world of dark. Harmless fruit bats dash above my head, their sonar avoiding collisions with rock and human at the last possible moment.
Oh my God, that is disgusting.
Pablo picks up a giant scorpion spider, possibly the most revolting I've ever encountered.
Dear Mom, I hope you're seeing this. I hope you're looking at this. I hope you're looking what your son's become. Look what travel writing's done to me. Goodbye, thank you. Cool. Lucky Julia wasn't around because she would have eaten that guy.
It is a 1 hour hike to reach the waterfalls.
Oh, time to get wet.
We pass narrow, slippery channels, careful to avoid touching or breaking the thousands of impressive stalactites dripping from the ceiling.
It's unbelievable, it's incredible.
Layered white limestone rocks form stunning natural formations, with water flowing from layer to layer like champagne over a glass pyramid. Here we are, deep in the planet, our headlamps providing the only comfort from the void.
All right, an hour of just amazing hiking in the depths of the planet. And here come the waterfalls.
It would have been great to catch a jungle rat in the heart of the Belizean jungle. But like the crocodiles, stories don't always go as planned. Ching has something else in mind that I can definitely catch.
All right, Julia, I found a good termite's nest over here. So if you look at it, see it right here?
Oh, ew.
Look at this, Julia. There's plenty of it here. Well, here you go.
Now I'll do one or two. Oh, they're everywhere, they're all over me.
You can try it. They've got a little minty taste.
A minty taste, mm-hmm. Wow, okay. Tastes like carrot. How much you eat. Oh, not that bad. Thanks. You take me up to all the best spots. You really know how to woo a woman. If I have to stay overnight, where am I going to stay?
Well, we're going to be building a shelter right here. Okay?
Okay.
So we're going to put this stick across.
Yeah.
Okay. So you hold that end right over there for me?
Yes.
You've got to wear vines here to tie with.
Any particular knot you'd like?
For now, just wrap it around so it keeps it up.
It's a good foundation.
Yeah.
For our shelter.
Okay.
Nice.
Now, let's go grab our leaf. It's right over here.
What kind of palm is this?
Bay palm.
Bay palm.
Cute. And just throw it on top. When you put layers on top of layers, it actually helps a lot.
Okay. Okay. Okay in there? Well, I think we did pretty good.
I think so.
Yeah. So do you think I could survive out here on my own?
I think you can.
Oh God, really?
After an hour of hiking, we've reached our goal, the waterfall cave.
I've been caving and I've been canyoneering before, but I've never been canyoneering in a cave.
This is canyoneering, the art of rock climbing up waterfalls. My hands struggle and slip to find grips, my feet clumsily seeking out footholds as the gush of water bruises my thigh. I finally hoist myself up to the top, scream in triumph, drenched, utterly elated. I steady myself on the edge, begin the countdown, and take rock jumping to a whole new subterranean level. Fast-flowing waterfall might not sound like much, but in the confined space of a cave, it is something to behold.
Woo!
Down, down, baby. That's where you gotta go.
I knew there was more to Belize than the reef and the coast. You know, I had to dig a little deeper, but that was amazing. That was just spelunking. What a story.
Our ancestors lived in caves for thousands of years, and exploring their legacy is serious fun for the adventurous tourist. The real pleasure, however, comes from the re-emergence into the world in which we belong.
If there's one thing I've learned, it's that the jungle has everything you could need to survive. You just have to know where to look.
I got an email from a reader suggesting I write an article about how travel writing has changed me as a person. And I actually don't know where to start.
Well, we travel all the time, so that kind of changes things. I mean, I am always away from the people that I love.
Which is kind of cute when we pulled through Toronto the other day and you had coffee with your parents at the airport.
I know, it's the only time I can see them. You know? And that takes a toll.
If we continue traveling the way we do, will things start to look the same? Will we run out of drive, energy, or story ideas?
Fortunately, when you travel, something unexpected always happens. It's those surprises that keep things fresh. As if right on schedule, something surprising appears right here in the middle of Belize.
A Mennonite settlement in the heart of the jungles of Belize may seem like a hallucination brought on by the intense humidity, but this is no illusion.
There are some 5,000 Mennonites living in this small Central American country, and some communities welcome visiting tourists.
Women in bonnets suited up in woolly winter frocks. Men dressed in overalls and straw cowboy hats.
Hello.
I think Bolivia has about 50 or more communities.
We meet Abe, a respected member of the community, who agrees to show us around.
And so there's no technology, right?
No.
Cell phones, no television, no computer.
No.
The Mennonites are a Protestant religious sect.
Belize's government welcomes them and praises their farming expertise, which accounts for much of the country's produce. They live a simple life in closed farming communities.
So this is the local corner store where all the community Hello. Come to get everything they need, from medicine to corn chips. It's amazing to see. I mean, our society is so dependent on technology. And here we are, horse and buggy community.
Very Twilight Zone-y. This is a weird energy, but it's cool. They're okay with tourists coming, and didn't expect this in Belize. You know, jungle and Mennonites. With bank loans and bad weather, life is hard and times are tough for the farmers. Mennonites share many of the same problems as the rest of us.
What have we come here for? Although we've been to the jungle before, our week in Belize offered something different. Though I've traveled and seen a lot, our time here has shown me that there is always something new to discover and to share with my readers.
Sure, I may have missed Belize's coral reefs and beaches. And yes, the rain did wash away our chances to learn about crocodiles. But that's okay, because if you do everything the first time, there's less reason to return.
How many travel artists does it take to canoe?
Yeah, that's it, Julia.
I've canoed before.
How do you know?
Yeah, I got to deal with Robin, the anti-paddler.
The anti-paddler.
One travel.